na novinarski konferenci slovensko reprezentanco s selektorjem Srečkom Katancem. Šli bomo kar na vaše vprašanja, oziroma Srečko, da ima najprej.
No, zelo nakratko, pošteno čestitati Angliji za mogoče nezasluženo zmago, ampak tako pač nogomet je, dali so gol, mi ga nismo dali, tako da čestitke, srečno na svetovnem prvenstvu. Kar se pa nas tiče, mislim, da smo odigrali izredno dobro in solidno tekmo. Žal nismo zabili gola v nogometu, če ga ne daš, je pač to tako, da tekmo na koncu potem izgubiš, ampak mi smo morali tekmo zmagati, ker točka nam ne bi igrala nič, tako da smo poskušali in fantje so lahko ponosni, glave lahko dajo gor, tako da svetovnega prvenstva žal ni, ampak poskušali smo pa dejansko vse, da bi prišli še do zadnje tekme, da bi bili v igri, ampak se ni išlo in to je to.
Yes, first congratulations to England. They maybe not really deserve this victory, but they scored a goal. I wish them good luck at the next World Cup. We played a very good game. Our goal was to win. One point, it wouldn't be enough to get to the World Cup. But I think my players deserve congratulations as well, and I think we played a decent game and they can be proud.
Hvala, gremo kar na vaše vprašanje.
Question, please.
Seveda, taktični plan, vse, kar smo predvideli pred tekmo, je šlo v to smer. Točno vedel sem, da če preživimo pod narekovaji do 60-70 minute, da ga ne dobimo, potem zamenjavami še pojačati ritem z Valterjem in drugimi, ki so not prišli, mislim, da je to vse bilo, tudi videli se je, da je bilo temu tako, da smo bili boljši, drugi počas, predvsem sem jaz videl, da smo mi bili boljša ekipa. Seveda nam manjka nekaj pred naprej, malo bolj, ne vem, direktnosti, malo bolj pokvarjenosti pod narekovaji, ampak to je to, mi smo taki dejansko po današnji tekmi, lahko fantom sam še enkrat čestitam in ne dajo glave gor, imamo še eno tekmo odigrati na najboljši možni način in kvalifikacije so končane.
Yeah, so the question was the tactical plan was done, was realized on the pitch, yes, of course, they played really well, our plan was to resist till 60th, 17th minute and then attack, maybe score a goal. And I think in the second half we were a better team, but what can we do now? I think my players can be proud of what they shown tonight, and we have one match ahead and just they need to play it, put the hands up and that's it. Next questions. Kaj pomeni ta poraz za vas osebno in za slovenski nogomet?
Za mene ta poraz, jaz si ga štejem, mogoče v trenerski karieri si mogoče štejem med pet boljših tekem, kar sem jih jaz vodil in kar sem jih jaz postavil. Tako da za slovenski nogomet pa pomeni, da pač žal ni svetovnega prvenstva, smo pa v zadnjem periodu, odkar sem jaz tukaj, je prišlo in prihaja še do menjave generacij, tako da tudi, kar se tega vidika tiče, mislim, da ima slovenska reprezentanca lepo prihodnost za naprej. Vključili smo več kot 10 novih igralcev. Seveda bo pa odvisno samo od tega, ali bojo oni v klubih se razvijali na način takšen pravi, kot morajo, da bojo imeli minutažo, da igrajo iz tedna v teden, ker v zadnjem periodu, v zadnjem leta, mi pač nismo te sreče, da bi imeli igralce v takih klubih, da bi kontinuirano igrali in to se seveda, na koncu se to pozna na igrišču, tako da.
Yeah, for me personally, this defeat, it was a defeat, but anyway, it was between my top five games as tactically prepared, so I'm very satisfied. For Slovenian football, that means no World Cup, but we were during these qualifiers, and we are still trying to change the generation. This was one of the projects, and we involved 10 new players, 10 new young players, and I think they just need to continue this way. I had some difficulties because our players were not playing continuously all the time, but I think there's a bright future in front of us.
Naslednje vprašanje.
Next question, please.
Ne, bo moja zadnja, tako da.
Ste rekel, ja. Da, bo moja zadnja.
Tekma bo moja zadnja, ja.
Yeah, is the next match against Scotland your last match as a coach of the national team? Yes, this is going to be my last coach as a national, as a coach of the national team.
Če še kakšno vprašanje?
Nič ne obžalujem. V nogometu ni časa za žalovanje. Jaz sem ponosen na vseeno to, kaj si vi mislite, slovenski mediji. Vem, kakšno delo smo opravili v zadnjih letih. Tako da pravim, da se ne ponavljam. Vse bo odvisno, reprezentanca ima neko okostje, kar veliko igralcev smo dali v reprezentanco, ki imajo potencial, seveda želim pa slovenski reprezentanci in fantom tem, da se razvijajo v pravo smer. Samo to je ključ, da bo lahko reprezentanca na koncu končno takšne tekme, kakor je današnja, zmagala. Ne? To je samo razlika, je samo v tem v minutaži, igrajo se, lejte, danes je bila tekma v četrtek, dobimo se v ponedeljek, naredimo pol treninga in igralci morajo igrati. To je za nepripravljenimi igralci, ki nimajo minutaže, ki nimajo vere, ki nimajo samozavesti, apsolutno nemogoče delo. Tako da to je realnost, to ni moj alibi, daleč od tega, če se gleda rezultat in če je kdo mislil, da smo mi dejansko favoriti, da gremo na svetovno prvenstvo, potem naj misli, potem je to velik neuspeh, ampak jaz pravim, treba je situacijo analizirati, sem na koncu koncev dejansko ponosen na to, kar sem delal zadnji period, če se pa gleda rezultatsko, po vaše, ni svetovnega prvenstva in je neuspeh. Imate pravico analizirati tudi tako, surovo skozi rezultat.
Yeah, the question was, are there any regrets about the qualifiers, about the matches you played? No, there's no regrets. I'm proud of what we have done. Maybe the media, the Slovenian media have different opinion, but I think we did a great job. We don't have so much time to prepare the matches. If the players are not playing continuously in their clubs, then I have a big problem. So we have a before every match, we have 2-3 days to prepare the matches, and I really miss this continuously playing of the players in their clubs. But I did what I should have to do, and I'm really proud about my job. And the most important thing is that I'm proud, I'm satisfied, and I think the players can do it much better in the next qualifiers. I'm sorry we didn't made it to the World Cup. This is the most important thing for the media, but this is what we have now, and I'm totally proud of my job.
Hvala lepa, če je še kakšno zadnje vprašanje. Sicer pa hvala.
Hvala.
Good luck.
Ja, tudi vam.
Na novinarski konferenci slovensko reprezentanco s selektorjem Srečkom Katancem. Šli bomo kar na vaše vprašanja, oziroma Srečko, da ima najprej.
No, zelo nakratko, pošteno čestitati Angliji za mogoče nezasluženo zmago, ampak tako pač nogomet je, dali so gol, mi ga nismo dali, tako da čestitke, srečno na svetovnem prvenstvu. Kar se pa nas tiče, mislim, da smo odigrali izredno dobro in solidno tekmo. Žal nismo zabili gola, v nogometu, če ga ne daš, je pač to tako, da tekmo na koncu potem izgubiš, ampak mi smo morali tekmo zmagati, ker točka nam ne bi igrala nič, tako da smo poskušali in fantje so lahko ponosni, glave lahko dajo gor, tako da svetovnega prvenstva žal ni, ampak poskušali smo pa dejansko vse, da bi prišli še do zadnje tekme, da bi bili v igri, ampak se ni išlo in to je to.
Yes, first congratulations to England. They maybe not really deserve this victory, but they scored the goal. I wish them good luck at the next World Cup. We played a very good game. Our goal was to win. 1 point, it wouldn't be enough to get to the World Cup. But I think my players deserve congratulations as well, and I think we played a decent game and they can be proud.
Hvala, gremo kar na vaše vprašanje.
Question, please.
Seveda, taktični plan, vse, kar smo predvideli pred tekmo, je šlo v to smer. Točno vedel sem, da če preživimo pod narekovaji do 60-70 minute, da ga ne dobimo, potem zamenjavami še pojačati ritem z Valterjem in drugimi, ki so not prišli, mislim, da je to vse bilo, tudi videl se je, da je bilo temu tako, da smo bili boljši, drugi počas, predvsem sem jaz videl, da smo mi bili boljša ekipa. Seveda nam manjka nekaj prud naprej, malo bolj, ne vem, direktnosti, malo bolj pokvarjenosti pod narekovaje, ampak to je to, mi smo taki dejansko po današnji tekmi, lahko fantom sam še enkrat čestitam in ne dajo glave gor, imamo še eno tekmo odigrati na najboljši možni način in kvalifikacije so končane.
Yeah, so the question was the tactical plan was done, was realized on the pitch, yes, of course, they played really well, our plan was to resist till 60th, 17th minute and then attack, maybe score a goal. And I think in the second half we were a better team, but what can we do now? I think my players can be proud of what they've shown tonight, and we have one match ahead and just they need to play it, put the hands up and that's it. Next questions. Kaj pomeni ta poraz za vas osebno in za slovenski nogomet?
Za mene ta poraz, jaz si ga štejem, mogoče v trenerski karieri si mogoče štejem med pet boljših tekem, kar sem jih jaz vodil in kar sem jih jaz postavil. Tako da za slovenski nogomet pa pomeni, da pač žal ni svetovnega prvenstva, smo pa v zadnjem periodu, odkar sem jaz tukaj, je prišlo in prihaja še do menjave generacij, tako da tudi, kar se tega vidika tiče, mislim, da ima slovenska reprezentanca lepo prihodnost za naprej. Vključili smo več kot 10 novih igralcev. Seveda bo pa odvisno samo od tega, ali bojo oni v klubih se razvijali na način takšen pravi, kot morajo, da bojo imeli minutažo, da igrajo iz tedna v teden, ker v zadnjem periodu, v zadnjem leta mi pač nismo te sreče, da bi imeli igralce v takih klubih, da bi kontinuirano igrali in to se seveda na koncu se to pozna na igrišču, tako da.
Yeah, for me personally, this defeat, it was a defeat, but anyway, it was between my top five games as tactically prepared, so I'm very satisfied. For Slovenian football, that means no World Cup, but we were during these qualifiers and we are still trying to change the generation. This was one of the projects and we involved 10 new players, 10 new young players, and I think they just need to continue this way. I had some difficulties because our players were not playing continuously all the time, but I think there's a bright future in front of us. Next question, please.
Ne, bo moja zadnja, tako da.
Ste rekel, ja. Da, bo moja zadnja.
Tekma bo moja zadnja, ja.
Yeah, is the next match against Scotland your last match as a coach of the national team? Yes, this is going to be my last coach as a national, as a coach of the national team.
Če še kakšno vprašanje?
Nič ne vprašanje. V nogometu ni časa za žalovanje. Jaz sem ponosen na vseeno to, kaj si vi mislite, slovenski mediji. Vem, kakšno delo smo opravili v zadnjih letih, tako da pravim, da se ne ponavljam. Vse bo odvisno, reprezentanca ima neko okostje, kar veliko igralcev smo dali v reprezentancov, ki imajo potencial, seveda želim pa slovenski reprezentanci in fantom tem, da se razvijajo v pravo smer. Samo to je ključ, da bo lahko reprezentanca na koncu takšne tekme, kolikor je današnja, zmagala. Ne? To je samo razlika, je samo v tem v minutaži, igrajo se, lejte, danes je bila tekma v četrtek, dobimo se v ponedeljek, naredimo pol treninga in igralci morajo igrati. To je za nepripravljenimi igralci, ki nimajo minutaže, ki nimajo vere, ki nimajo samozavesti, apsolutno nemogoče delo. Tako da to je realnost, to ni moj alibi, daleč od tega, če se gleda rezultat in če je kdo mislil, da smo mi dejansko favoriti, da gremo na svetovno prvenstvo, potem naj misli, potem je to velik neuspeh, ampak jaz pravim, treba je situacijo analizirati, sem na koncu koncev dejansko ponosen na to, kar sem delal zadnji period. Če se pa gleda rezultatsko, po vaše, ni svetovnega prvenstva, mi je neuspeh. Imate pravico analizirati tudi tako. Surovo skozi rezultat.
Yeah, the question was, are there any regrets about the qualifiers, about the matches you played? No, there's no regrets. I'm proud of what we have done. Maybe the media, the Slovenian media have different opinion, but I think we did a great job. We don't have so much time to prepare the matches. If the players are not playing continuously in their clubs, then I have a big problem. So we have before every match, we have 2-3 days to prepare the matches, and I really miss this continuously playing of the players in their clubs. But I did what I should have to do, and I'm really proud about my job. And the most important thing is that I'm proud, I'm satisfied, and I think the players can do it much better in the next qualifiers. I'm sorry we didn't make it to the World Cup. This is the most important thing for the media, but this is what we have now, and I'm totally proud of my job.
Hvala lepa, če je še kakšne zadnje vprašanje.
Hvala.
Good luck.
Ja, tudi vam.